Graded stakes racing continues, and this time we go to Gulfstream Park, South Florida for Pegasus Day. It is the Filly and Mare's Turf. They're going to be mowing the lawn, a grade two race. It did draw a full field. It's going to be on Saturday, January the 27th, race number 10. It's part of an exciting pick five and pick six at Gulfstream Park. It did draw a field of 14, including two also eligibles. Let's run down this field, starting off with number one, Cairo Concert, who goes for trainer Todd Pletcher. This one comes in 12 lifetime starts, four wins, but two for four at Gulfstream with a third. Chad Brown sends out Chili Flag. She adds some international spice to this one. The Thoroughbred, 15 starts, four wins, set 6 seconds. Flavian Pratt rides Chili Flag. Accomplished Girl, a tough luck loss the last time. Second place to Full Count Felicia, who is also entered in this race. The most likely favorite is Star Fortress. She's 5-2. Her United States debut was a 10-length win at Churchill Downs in November for trainer Sherry DeVoe. Full Count Felicia, 1-for-1 at Gulfstream Park. The daughter of Warfront picked up a win at Gulfstream Park in the Suwannee River Stakes after riding the rail down the lane. Ruby Nell ships in from Santa Anita, could be the speed of the speed. 5 wins and 10 lifetime starts. Man O Mandela is the trainer. Ruby Nell, the winner of the Lady Shamrock and the Autumn Mist Stakes. Meanwhile, Chad Brown's second runner in the race is Slumber, a 6-year-old mare. 5 wins, 9 seconds. You know, she's ran in a bunch of grade ones, was 5th in the Diana Stakes, 4th in the Rodeo Drive, and tries to pick up a grade two win here. A tough luck second the last time out in the Matriarch Stakes, a grade one. She gets Irad Ortiz for Fluffy Socks. Queen Goddess, another contender. Michael McCarthy trains the 6-year-old, looking for that grade one. She ran evenly in the Matriarch, 2nd in the Goldakova, was 3rd in the Gamely Stakes, did run in the Pegasus World Cup turf, and won it last year at 4-1 for Queen Goddess as she goes for the repeat with Tyler Gaff Leone. Didia, the hard-hitting Argentina mare, 9 wins and 14 starts. Ran in the Breeders' Cup Filly and Mare Turf earlier last year, picked up a win in a couple of stakes races at the fairgrounds and also on Derby Day, the Modesty Stakes, a grade three. Sister Luann, out of post position, number 10, 20-1 on the morning line. Mission of Joy for Graham Motion, 3rd in the Queen Elizabeth Cup in October at Keeneland, and then also 7th in the Belmont Oaks Invitational. Surprisingly, another one with Saratoga form, a second place finish at Monmouth, and a third place finish at Tampa last year in the Hillsborough Stakes. Be My Sunshine, that one's one to take a look at. She's also eligible with Paco Lopez, 8 starts, 3 lifetime wins, but it could get in this field along with Tass. That is a look at the 14 horses entered in the Pegasus World Cup Filly and Mare Turf. Morning line favorite is Star Fortress. Fluffy Socks is 9-2. Didia 6-1. And Ruby Nell 8-1. Shipping in from the West Coast. I do want to take a look at Mission of Joy. Let's take a look at the race replays as we show you how they got here. I think on the betting board, Star Fortress is going to be favored. Fluffy Socks going to take some money. But also don't overlook Didia. Meanwhile, Star Fortress, let's go back to Churchill Downs. Her American debut, a win by 10 lengths, and this was an impressive effort. Exploded down the lane, went from last to first, 8 starts lifetime, 2 wins, but has to go up to that grade two class. She's by See the Stars, Star Fortress, 5-2 on the morning line, shipping in here from Churchill Downs. Chili Flag, Chad Brown trainee, wins the Forever Together. 1 win and 1 start at Gulfstream. Chili Flag, another one to consider, could be coming off the pace to try to mow him down late. Full Count Felicia was able to ride the rail the last time out. That was winning the Suwannee River, a rail trip. The sire is Warfront. Full Count Felicia with some Gulfstream form, but gas to go up a little bit in class from that race. Ruby Nell, impressive effort in the autumn miss. We go back to that one. She opened up by 6-7 lengths, ended up winning by 3. She also pretty much went wire to wire in the Lady Shamrock Stakes. Richard Mandela trains Ruby Nell in the Grade 2 Filly and Mare Turf on Pegasus Day. And then Fluffy Socks, another one to consider. Second in the Matriarch. She had the lead. She's on the outside. And then the rail horse gets up. Chad Brown trains the sire of Slumber. A lot of seconds, but Fluffy Socks does win every now and then. She's always the kind of right price, 4-1, 7-2, 5-1. If you can get her in there, she's the type of horse that can spice up a pick 5 or a pick 4 or even a daily double. Fluffy Socks trying to make it a win here after running second in the Matriarch Stakes the last time out. Lots of questions to answer in the Filly and Mare Pegasus Stakes. It's a Grade 2, race number 10, Star Fortress. Can she go up in class, ship in from Churchill Downs for Sherry DeVoe? Ruby Nell, she's got some speed, has to face some other horses, goes up a little bit in class. The turf hunt runners out in California were not as strong in 2023. And then you've got Fluffy Stocks. Sometimes she's a bridesmaid, sometimes she grabs all the money. We'll see if she can do it here out of a nice post position for trainer Chad Brown as you handicap the Grade 2 Pegasus Filly and Mare Turf. My top selection is going to be Star Fortress. I like that impressive debut in America. I think the price will be right, 2-1. Has to transfer that form to Gulfstream. Exactas, I'm gonna play her with Fluffy Socks, who likes to run second. Chili Flag and Full Count Felicia. Chili Flag is another one you may wanna consider here in the Pegasus Filly and Mare Turf. Don't forget, Pegasus Day is Saturday. 3 big races with full fields. You've got the Pegasus Turf, $1 million, Masterpiece, Ad Hamo, Web Slinger, and then the favorite, Undefeated Integration, goes in that one. I've got a full preview of up on that race on the channel. You can watch that preview and see who I've got later on this week. And then the Pegasus Grade 1, $3 million on the dirt, 1 1/8 miles. The morning line favorite is National Treasure. First Mission is also 7-2. Grand Aspen, 8-1. I've got a preview of the Pegasus Grade 1 on the dirt. That is already up on the channel. Lots of contenders in these 3 full field stakes races, Saturday, January 27th. If you want my picks for all the stakes races, subscribe to the Racing Notebook. About 20 times this year, we'll put out picks on the big racing days. Our first one was last week, Le Comp Day. Sign up in the description below. And also, don't forget the Triple Crown Prospectus. 2,000 words every Monday. It's free. Sign up in the description below. And we talk about the Triple Crown fillies, Oaks fillies, Derby horses, recaps of the stakes races. Who do you like in the Filly and Mare Turf Pegasus Day? Leave a comment. Star Fortress, Sister Luann, Didia, and Queen Goddess. And remember, as Dwayne Lucas says, people have opinions, horses have the facts at Pegasus Day.